Hi there, Brian King again. I want to start by saying that I did something very important, I think, with my largest group here on Facebook. It previously just focused on mindfulness, you know, being present in the moment, enjoying and being grateful for what life brings to you. But now I've decided to make it a lot more specific. I've decided to focus it much more on how mindfulness shows up in the role of fatherhood. Because I've been noticing more and more, and I've also been being told that fathers are really being underserved in terms of being guided and how to be more connected to their own emotions, how to be much more heart-centered in their parenting, something that I've spent my entire life as a parent learning how to really dive deep into and make it a significant part of not only who I am as a father, but who I am as a person. Hey, Roseanne, thank you for joining me. So I want to let you know that the group is now called Zen Inspired Fatherhood. And I will put a link in the header of this once this is done. But with that, I want to go into something that really can plague us as adults, whether you're a father, whether you're a mother. And that plague is this sense of lifelong victimhood, this sense that the world happens to you. Now, I'm thinking about this specifically in the context of having a traumatic incident happen when you're young. This could be the loss of a parent, whether through divorce or your parent dies. This could be a childhood illness. This could be bullying. But here's where the difficulty lies. And I just had this conversation a few times over the past couple days. Where you take a traumatic event, like one of these things that I mentioned, disease, losing a parent, and you decide to make that one event the basis for how you then engage the world. There's no doubting that these things happen, that they're hard. I was maliciously bullied as a child. I had cancer when I was 18. My oldest son was bullied by teachers, the principal. He was suicidal when he was an elementary school student. A good friend of mine lost her father when she was very young to a drunk driver. And these things can hit you at such a primal level, at your sense of who you are and your sense of whether the world is safe or not, that at a very young age, you can declare that the world sucks, the world is a bad place, the world is mean to me, the world did this. But as a child, we lack the perspective of knowing that life can go on, life can get better. Because one of the things, hey Shirley, one of the things that I realized in having to overcome my cancer experience. Now, you know me now, how I am with my present attitude some 28 years later. At the time, I was filled with rage and bitterness and resentment, depression, every negative emotion you can imagine, I was feeling times 10. I was wallowing in this sense that the universe had conspired to do me wrong. And I had all the beliefs to support that too. And it kept me stuck for a couple years. But when I finally decided I didn't want to live there, that I wanted life to feel more abundant, I wanted more opportunity, I wanted to open my heart to trust again. And I did some hard work. I can't emphasize it enough, hard work. It wasn't like flipping a switch. It was taking baby steps. It was sticking my toe into the deep end of the pool and a little bit more, testing the water, getting a sense of whether this world I wanted to step into was something I was ready for. It took some time. But here's what I know now, 28 years later, that when I look back at my cancer experience, I don't look back upon it with rage, resentment, depression. I look back on it with some perspective. When people give you the advice that, hey, life doesn't happen to you, life happens for you. Bad advice when somebody's in the moment. Okay? This is a perspective that you have when you've gone through that crap and you've learned that in time, you can look back at it and suddenly the story's a little different. The story's no longer, hey, that was horrible, it sucked, it never should have happened. The story's now, Man, that was a rough time. But now looking back, I can see how I've grown from it. I can see what opportunities it gave me. I can see how it opened my eyes to new resources and new relationships. This kind of realization comes with time and work and healing. Except for those people that hang on to that event and use it to determine their relationship with life. So if this is something that you're kind of stuck with, you had maybe an alcoholic parent, you had an abusive parent, you had something terrible happen, and now you see this coming up for you over and over and over again when you're raising your own kids. And you realize it's poison. You know your kids deserve better. You know you deserve better. But you just don't know what to do about it. That's why I repurposed that group, my mindfulness group, and turned it into Zen-inspired fatherhood. And keep in mind, if you're not a guy, you're not excluded. Because even if you're not a father, you've had a father. Maybe you still do have a father, if he's still in your life. And learning this approach to fatherhood can help you learn to support that father that for whatever reason didn't measure up to your expectations or did hurtful things. Maybe intentional, maybe not. Maybe they were coming from his own hurt. I know in terms of my father, he carried around a ridiculous amount of emotional pain. And in his 70s, he just started talking about it 5 years ago. So it's amazing what kind of shadows we can carry with us. But if you're kind of in the mix now, you're still actively parenting, and you're saying to yourself, man, I don't want to keep going like this, but I don't know what to do. I don't know how to talk about it. I don't know who to talk about it to. That's why I'm putting myself out there in this way. For fathers that want to have that conversation about how to move forward, learn to be present with their children, learn to start over instead of repeating the past. It's doable. I help parents do it all the time, but it's work. Don't expect a quick solution. Don't expect to flip a switch, but do expect to make progress if you're ready, if you want to have that conversation. So as I mentioned, I'm going to put a link in the header here to my new Zen-inspired fatherhood group where we can have a bigger discussion. Tell me what other topics. Yes, single moms are fathers. Single moms are incredible parents, Rose. And they need an incredible amount of support. And I hope that in some way, Rose, you're finding that support from me and what I do here. And if there's more I can do for you, please let me know. Because if I can't provide the help, I'll find the person that can, because I have one heck of a community here. So tell me what other topics you'd like me to discuss. I have a group for parenting kids with ADHD. And I also have a group for parents that just simply want to be more present, mindful, more heart-centered, instead of driven by the fear and the pain of the past. So I hope this has been helpful. If there's anything you want to talk to me about in private, any problem at all, just private message me. I'm here to help. And if there's anybody that you think can benefit from this message, maybe a real special father who just doesn't know how to walk beyond the past, please share this with him. Please introduce us so that I can support him as well. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. I really appreciate it. This is Brian, and we'll talk again soon.